Hello, everybody. My name is Omar, and today I'm playing Alan Wake Remastered. I know nothing about this game. All I know, there's a sequel coming out in October that I can't wait to play. So with that being said, let's dive into this horror adventure story.
And there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always
had so dark and mischievous.
But this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker.
Oh my God. So did we just kill somebody? Is he alive?
He was dead.
Oh, he's dead.
I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Who's Alice? Oh my God. Oh hell. This ain't nothing to play about.
Suddenly,
his body was gone. Oh, they got episodes.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Street light. No. Okay. Hold down a sprint. That's kind of far, huh? Oh my God. Oh my God.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're gone?
We're supposed to run? Can we jump? Oh my God. Don't die. What if we not looking back? I know that. Go. Oh my God.
You missed your deadline.
That's the person we just ran over. L1.
You can't stop me.
What? Dodge what attack? Oh, we gotta fight him? Okay. I guess I'm not. Oh my God, can we just go past them? Oh my God. How are we not dead yet? Now, okay. Now I'm getting a little confused. Okay.
The hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Oh. Interesting.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your oppression?
Oh no, we gotta go. Is this as fast as he can go? He can not go faster than this? Oh my god. Run. Is this an ally? It's so loud, I can barely hear myself. Hello, Clay. Yes, let's go inside. It's loud. It's locked from the outside? He can see that person? Oh no, bullets ain't working. He ugly.
I was trapped.
There
was no way out.
The TV talking. What is this? What are we supposed to do? Oh, like how it's getting intense. No. Should we not?
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
How do we get out? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, don't mind. The door wouldn't open at first. Follow the light.
You should go into the light.
Okay. Go through the safe haven. Huh? The light is safe? Okay, the light heals us.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For you did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
I do not understand. Who is talking to us? Oh, we get ammo. Get all of it. Limit reach.
You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away.
So when he's a light, he's vulnerable.
Here, take the light.
Where?
Turn the flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Oh yeah.
Now the no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is
so
still
how do we?
Enemy.
I'm so.
Here, take the gun.
Thank you.
Now you're gone.
There we go. Oh, square.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
What you mean?
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness
I'm
was taking over.
So confused right now.
The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Ooh, trophy. No. No. Oh, you want mo? I ain't scared no mo. Yep, he's out of here. Let's go! See? Now I'm wasting bullets. Yeah, you scared of life, huh? It's open. Ooh, flare gun. You love ammo. Okay, White House. It's three. I like that. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. You're out of breath.
I can keep this up
forever. Let me go this way. Run. Oh my god. No time to go slow right now. What are you doing? It's a big tornado. What's this? Why is it glowing? Coffee? Oops. We made it. We made it. Are we good? We're good. I'm so confused. So he's haunted by his stories. No, thank you.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare.
Okay.
Everything game. Fine. You dozed off.
Right.
I'm dozed off. No. For everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Welcome to Bright Falls. Horror awaits. All right, okay, what do we do?
Like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure.
One gentleman.
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Hello, sir.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, yeah, Pat.
I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you're
sorry.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be with you. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
It's like the town from that one story game. Tell me why.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. You made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah.
Oh, I'm calling with Barry.
Who's giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay?
Okay, Barry.
Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
That you
what
can.
Did I tell you?
Listen to him again.
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Which one is ours? The red one? Yes.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Should not trust us or something?
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns.
Oh, wow.
Everybody knew everybody.
We're famous.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Oh, of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
Visit.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Okay.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
You can tell he's creeped out right now. Oh my God, a hallway just flashing.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox.
Okay, well, I see coffee.
I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
Okay, Sonny.
Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
What? What song he wanted?
Yeah, you need to do it a good...
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Excuse me?
I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Oh. Oh, no.
Hello? Mr.
Is he in here?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill.
Who is this?
But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Uh-uh.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And
How you know I'm married? Is she creepy?
I insist.
Thanks.
Let's leave.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Oh my god, how she talking.
You're lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I'm out of this place.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you alright?
Let's just leave.
They're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Somebody just pulled up here.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Bye.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Thank you.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
This thing, that's the man we ran over.
That diner was a real nut house.
I've seen a dream.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBF FM.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago.
Oh, wow.
I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks from the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you.
Yeah.
It's pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's very pretty.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
Speed up, girl.
I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Yeah. I won't be outside when it's dark either. She's so far behind. She even... Okay. This cussing gonna trigger her and... Here we go.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing.
Oh, she's... Okay. She's that scared. Oh, I hear footsteps.
Hello? Anyone here?
Can she come in the house with me? This took a turn, huh? Oh, that girl from Madonna. Gotta be her.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Damn.
Don't do that.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box somewhere on the island.
I don't like that. Now I'm on edge. This room is a no-go.
The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
I'm hella nervous. She can't surprise us. Go. Let's go back outside.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Thank you, honey. Examine.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
We can only hope. We can only hope. Where's the opening? Oh, here it is.
The generator had been connected to the power cable.
Uh-huh. Let there be light. This should make... This mean the house is good now.
Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Wait for me, please.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
What do you mean, look around? No, thank you.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
You touched that dirty window. Why are you so far from the house? Uh-oh, there's a basement. Where's she at?
Alice? Honey?
She was just in the fucking window. Uh-uh.
I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well,
oh.
Hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Can you come with me?
Okay.
I'm looking at you. Why are door closed? Typewriter.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I thought he don't want to work.
Confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You... Everyone keeps...
Hey! Just hear me out! There's a local
doctor... Someone got anger issues.
I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No! It's not like that! That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't! Just don't! I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice! God damn it! I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Did she not see us when she was just screaming his name?
Damn it. Alice?
Oh no. It's that
Alice!
Woman.
The cabin had gone dark.
No. Keep the light shining. Oh!
What the hell?
No! Run!
Stay away from me!
On a hot bird just jump scared us, but it did. She not upstairs still.
Oh no.
Go after your wife.
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Said bitch from the diner, y'all. I don't like this. Not one bit.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Thought she was in the water. How did a car get here?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma. By a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Get the fuck that out. What do we do? I'll go this way. I'm sorry. Oops. This way. Where's that flashlight?
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
So how would we get there? There goes our ride.
Hello?
Ooh, light.
Hello? Is someone there? The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started.
Oh?
I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Isn't that the dream we had? Oh, we clicked on the episode. Okay. Resume. Let me get out of suspect though. I want the flashlight out.
Anybody there?
Uh-uh.
Please.
I've seen somebody. Like the horror games go, we gotta follow what we saw. Me. I would have ran the other way, me personally.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Not all lights equals good things. Let me walk on this. No. I'm so confused. Do we or do we not walk on this? Okay, we do. What's the
fuck? Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Where is the flashlight?
Hey! Hey, you!
This is a cutscene.
There's been an accident. I need help. Listen. I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stucky.
Are we dreaming or are we not dreaming?
Non-refundable reservation deposit required.
No, okay.
Fair and square.
Yeah, I'm confused. This person alive? Is he chasing us? What do I do? We playing Ring Around the Rosie. Ooh. Okay. Oh no. It's like a werewolf, huh? Okay, Carl, you're not that scary. Maybe you are that scary.
Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
A flashlight, finally. Switch weapons.
During your trying, it's the latest thing.
Yes.
Great Wall Sheriff Station.
Hello? Hello?
He knocked the power line. Oh my god. Is this door open? That wasn't supposed to be scary. Oh wow, he got out there though. Okay, now it's time to go to the gas station. Battery. Come on. There we go.
With a concussion, I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone.
Okay.
Or something. There were no bodies.
We killed something, not someone.
If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go.
But where I had are you supposed no to go?
I had to get to the gas station.
If this thing still is going to electrocute us. Guess not. It's rabbit season. Motherfucker. We can pass that little line right there. Which means we gotta go in here. Ooh, Paige. You not climb this? No? Okay. Maybe it's worth the shot. See,
what the hell was that?
The wife dead. Let's just ignore her.
The river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
So how do we get across? Oh. Let's reload.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Let's not use our light yet. Man, where's the gas station? A girl. Okay. We just gotta run now. Let's no. Go. Get up. Go to the light. Fuck. We wasted 5 shots.
The staircase was broken.
Didn't even do nothing.
I had to make my way up some other way.
Some other way. Okay. Oh no, are they collectibles? Do we drink those? What is this? What do you mean, some other way? Turn off. Get away. Alan. We just did, but no. And now so we can fight them. Get your breath. now, let us do this. That took way longer than it needed to. As we were before. Sorry. Ooh, a shotgun. Love that. Boom, boom, use. We're moving this too. Moving this to us. I'm assuming it goes in the middle, right? Yeah, so we climb this. Sorry. Can I change that to X? Turn that on.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night.
Stay right in this light.
Most of you are probably in your beds
by now. I hear you from right there.
Feel up and around. Take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. Two listeners know what. I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, well, I don't have time.
Hello, Maurice. Who are you up to?
Pick it up. Where is it? Okay.
The gas station was closer now.
See something.
It's like welcoming in the darkness.
The best. That looks closer to you? That's far. Listen, whatever your name is. I got a shotgun for you. Oh my God, are we, what the hell? I'm stuck. I got stuck. We got bullets in here, right? We just had six shotgun bullets. I did not use. Okay. 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 So if you die, take away your ammo. Is that what I'm getting from this?
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best forms in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no curves. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is through.
What this shotgun do? Okay. Now, let's go back to the gas station. Did he disappear and I go on a light? Well, if that's the case, well, we gotta go towards him. I saw some glowing up over here. I'll take this. Well, I'm glad. Oh my God. I need health. Not a shortcut to this fucking gas station. Oh my God. I don't got that much batteries for these people. How about I just come here? Can they still get me? Are they backing away? Wasted 2 bullets, but okay. How about we just run? Alan, was I insulting you? Please back away. Go. Light. Here we go. Oh yes, we love ammo. Track there. Just run. Let's save ammo and just run. Well, that's a whole hurt. Stay away. Get away. I bet there's somebody in here waiting for me. Thank you. Another shotgun.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among
the world. We pressed some button. I don't know what it did. The cost for such a legacy is steep indeed. It did something.
In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already hidden, it would take a courageous
moment. I'm not interested. I'm sorry. I'm not interested in your sob story. That's where that big man was. We got a boss fight. Why are they giving us all this stuff? Yeah, 12 batteries, 42 bullets. Yeah, we got a boss fight. So why else would they give us all this shit? Use my shotgun for you, miss. Reload, 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 reload. Oh no, who is this using? Run. Are we stuck? Give me before I can see you, ho. Why he over there running? Is that supposed to open? First of all, let's reload. Something is blocking us from moving. We're supposed to kill him first. I don't know. Music is very intense, though. I do. You don't even have to be scared now. Oh, we got him.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares.
Wonder why that one opened.
Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
It was just intense. It wasn't scary.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage
what you mean?
Was a mess.
Why
it looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some
Of fight. It's some down there. Don't play like that.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel a presence in the dark. Just now.
Excuse me?
Perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up.
Excuse me?
Back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
The 68th annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, surprise competition, live music for the children. Bucktooth Charlie in the afternoons in Montgomery. Mystic Amazing P word evenings. Columbus Legendary Deer Fest Parade. I assume we gotta go downstairs. Oh, here's a phone right here.
Great Falls Sheriff Station.
We got somebody on the line. Oh, they came, thank goodness.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen. I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest.
Stucky owns this place?
She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
So we... Was that a ghost or did we actually kill him? I'm confused now. I'm guessing all the shit we just saw disappeared or did not exist in the first place. There's no car, huh? I'm still confused, everybody. That completes episode 1 of Alan Wake Remastered. I'm very confused. I'm very curious into what episode 2 brings to the table. And I'll see y'all next time. So, bye.